Good morning, dear students. Welcome back to our science class. Students, today we are going to start with our new chapter, that is chapter number 10, Adaptations, How Animals Survive. Students, in our last to last lecture, we had learned the same thing about plants. And can you now tell me what is adaptations? Students, the process of developing special features in the body to adjust in the surroundings is called as adaptations. And students, like plants, animals also have some special features in their bodies and which help them to live in this environment or in their environment. Students, the organisms or the animals that are able to adapt themselves in their surrounding can only survive, and those who are not able to adapt themselves, they will become extinct, that is, they will be no longer in this world. So it is necessary for each and every animal and plant to adapt their surroundings. So students, see, like plants, animals are also found all over the world, right? Forest, they live in deserts, they live in polar regions and many more. Students, some of the animals live on land, some of them live in water and some of them are in air. The students, just like you have a home, the animals also have their home, but it's their natural home, the natural place where an animal lives and grows is called its habitat. Okay, students? So, for a tiger, which is the habitat? Forest is its habitat. And for a fish, the water is its habitat. Do you understand now what is habitat? Now let's classify the animals according to their habitat. First one is terrestrial animals. Animals that live on land are called as terrestrial animals. Those who have their homes on land are called as terrestrial animals. And which animals are terrestrial animals? Tiger, lion, elephants, dogs, cats, camel, these all are terrestrial animals. Then students comes aquatic animals. Animals that live in water and spend their most of the time in the water only are called as aquatic animals. Now what are the examples of aquatic animals? Fishes, whales, dolphins, turtles, octopus, these all are aquatic animals. Students, amphibians. Amphibians are the animals that live both on the land and as well as in the water also, like a frog. You might have seen that frogs are able to live in water also and they are able to live on the land also. So, frog, toads, salamanders, these are some examples of amphibians. That is, they live both on the land also and in water also. Then students comes arboreal animals. So, which are the arboreal animals? Students, the animals that spend their most of the time on trees are called as arboreal animals. Like monkeys, gibbons, chimpanzees, lizards, tree lizards and all, squirrels, they spend their most of the time on the trees, and so they are called as arboreal animals. And at last students, there is aerial animals. Aerial means air. So the animals that fly and spend most of their time in the air are called as aerial animals. Animals like bats, birds and most of the insects are all aerial animals. So now we will see one by one the adaptations of this all types of animals according to their habitats. Let's see students adaptations in terrestrial animals. Students, terrestrial animals like elephants, lions, tigers, dogs, cats, they have legs to walk or run on the land, and also they have lungs to breathe. They have a well-developed sense organ and nervous systems also, so that they can feel in their surrounding, they can feel the changes in their surrounding. And students, some of the animals like snakes, they don't have legs. So what do? They have scales on their body, and the scales help them to crawl on that land. So they are also terrestrial animals. Now students, these terrestrial animals, terrestrial means whole land, right? So in that land, there are some of the regions. There are mountain regions which are very cold. There are desert regions which are very hot. And also there are polar regions which are very cold too. So let's see what type of animals have the adaptations over there. Okay students, so in deserts, you know students that deserts are very hot and dry places, and the water over there is very less. So the animals like camels and desert rats, they are found in the desert students, and they have a very thick skin with a very little hair on their body. And why there is very less hair? Because the hairs, it prevents water loss. And students, they have a very broad, flat and paddy soles, means their legs, soles are paddy. They are broad, flat and paddy. Why? Because that help them to move on the sand. Because of that, they have that paddy soles. Also students, they have long eyelashes which protect their eyes from sandstorm and sunlight. Students, but the mountain and polar regions are very cold as compared to deserts. And this mountain goats, yaks, they are found on mountains, while in polar regions there are polar bears and penguins, right? Students, these animals have a very thick fur on their body. They have very large amount of hairs on their body. And because of that body hairs, they are being kept warm. This fur on their body keeps them warm, students. And this polar bear, penguins, seals, they have a very thick layer of their underfat skin. And that underfat skin is called as blubber. And this underfat skin called blubber keeps them warm. So sometimes what they do, they use this underfat skin as their food also. And students, what about aquatic animals? Let's see the adaptations of aquatic animals. Students, you might have seen that most of the aquatic animals have a special shape, streamlined shape, that help them to swim. Students, fishes have fins, and turtles have flippers, and swans have webbed feet, which help them to move in that water. Because of that only they move in the water. And most of the animals, aquatic animals like fishes and crabs, how do they breathe? You know, they have gills. But students, the whales and dolphins, they have lungs in the body and they breathe through that lungs. Now what are the adaptations of amphibians? Students, as I said, amphibians are the animals which live both on the land and in water also. So these animals have moist skin to breathe in the water. They also have lungs, students. They also have lungs to breathe on the land. But they also have webbed feet to swim.
Sea students, amphibians like frogs and salamanders, they have very strong back legs and front legs also, which help them to hop and move on the land, students. Adaptations in arboreal animals. Animals like monkey, gibbons, koala bear, chimpanzees, they have, students, a very strong arms and legs to climb up and down of a tree for holding its branches. Students, they also have sharp claws, broad hip girdles that provide them support while climbing. And students, what are the adaptations in aerial animals? So, birds have boat-shaped bodies which help them to cut through the air. They have wings to fly and their bones are hollow that makes their body very light, which are able to fly. So, students, I hope that you have understood about the adaptations according to their habitats. So, students, now let's see the adaptations in their behavior. Students, some of the animals have different types of adaptations in their behavior, which help them to survive in extreme weather conditions. First one is hibernation. The deep sleep of some animals like polar bears, lizards, frogs, this sleeping during the winter, they are going into deep sleep, and this is called as winter sleep or hibernation. Students, during summer, they eat a lot of food. These animals eat a lot of food, and in winter, they become very inactive and they go into deep sleep because it is very cold in that regions. So, they go into deep sleep, and this deep sleep in the winter is called as hibernation. Same way, students, the deep sleep or long sleep of some animals like snakes, they sleep during the summer, and that summer sleep is called as estivation. What it is called as? Estivation. And students, you might have learned this word migration. So students, there are many animals, birds, what do? They migrate from one place to another. So, some birds like Siberian cranes live in very extreme cold places and they cannot survive in cold winters over there. So, what do? They leave their homes in the winter and they fly thousands of kilometers to warmer places in search of food and shelter. Students, they go back to their native places wherever the winter ends over there. So, once the winter ends, they go back to the place from where they have came from. Similarly, many other animals also regularly move from one place to another just to survive in the world, in that environment. And this seasonal mass movement of animals to a more favorable environment is called as migration. Students, you might have also seen that whales, humpback whales, that live in polar regions but move to the tropical regions or tropical oceans when winter comes. Why? For breeding.